Hey, we're in the Bear booth with Kevin Wilkerson. He's project manager for Bear Archery. Kevin, you got two new bows here this year. What have we got?
We've got, I'm holding the Arena 30, which is, of course, the shorter axle of the two, and you have the Arena 34. Both have very similar specs. Just to name off a few, it's got a 6.5-inch brace height. The 30 is a 30.5-inch axle-to-axle. The 34 is a 34.5-inch axle-to-axle.
They got a nice grip. It's got two different kind of materials, and there's something special about that?
Yeah, we've been doing this for a couple years. We've got an overmold rubber grip. For somebody, you know, when it gets cold outside and you don't want to touch that metal, you know, you can use that rubber grip. You can also take off the overmold grip, and there's two panel grips on the inside for somebody that likes a thinner grip and the feel of the metal.
Yeah, this is really nice because it's got a good tactile feel to it. So in cold weather, like Kevin said, in cold weather, it's really comfortable. And I like the two materials. It's got a unique feel to it.
Yeah, it's an overmold.
I also like a thin grip, so I like the ability, the option to take this off and add the two side panels to narrow down the grips. We've got two odd colors here in the archery industry. Tell me what we have.
Yeah, this year we kind of tried to do something a little bit different. You know, tactical type colors is kind of what we went after. So we went after a sand, and this is an olive. We're really excited about these. Both of these models actually come in sand, an olive, a Realtree AP Snow, a Realtree Extra Green, and of course the shadow finish.
I've noticed the trend in the past few years where bow manufacturers are going to black risers. What's the percentage, what's the interest rate on, like, if you've got a camo bow and a black bow, or the olive, or the sand, do you sell more of the camo, do you sell more of the black?
Always the camo is going to probably be the biggest seller. It'd probably be a shock if it wasn't. A lot of people are attracted to these colors. Right now, colors are really in. And, you know, new different colors are usually the exciting thing. So that's what we tried to do. Camo is going to be the majority of your sales because most of your, you know, we're going after bow hunters, and most of those people are going to be using it for hunting. But we do see a large spike in black. People still do like just black shadow bows. So it's kind of an interesting mix between that and these.
These have the traditional Bear, the dual string suppressors.
Yeah.
Is there something unique to those? Do you get better performance than off of a single one?
Yeah, we tend to see a pretty good rise in quiet. Obviously, we don't have the limb savers or anything like that coming OEM from the factory on these. And a lot of it has to do with these string suppressors. These are bi-dimensionally adjustable. So you can go left to right to adjust on the end of your string. You can go left to right, and you can go out and in. So you can adjust it to how much string is actually touching the dampener, so you can have a little bit less wear, and you can also adjust it just perfectly based on how your tune is on your bow.
I noticed you've got some vibration dampening in the riser. That's new, isn't it?
Yeah, that's new this year. The Agenda last year, that series kind of started this trend, and we're kind of just following through on it. One of the other things that we did this year at Bear is we actually have some color kits available this year. So for your arenas and your agendas, you can actually get a color kit that has the grip, the suppressors, the riser inserts, and the grip panels, and everything like that comes with it. It's an 11-piece kit, so we're pretty excited about that as well.
Two things viewers are going to want to know. Number one, what's the price? And number two, what's the speed?
Sure. So on the 30-inch axle-to-axle, the speed is 345 feet per second IBO. On the 34-inch version, it's 340 feet per second IBO. The price is an $899, which is our flagship price. And we're really excited about what this does. Another quick thing I want to talk about is on these bows, it does have the option of either cable stops or limb stops. So this year we have added limb stops onto these bows. And another cool thing is that you can actually keep both on if you wanted to. So you don't have to choose one or the other. If you wanted to, you could keep both on. You don't necessarily have to take off the cable stop if you want to set your limb stop.
What's the advantage to one or the other? Or is it just personal preference?
It tends to be personal preference. You know, a lot of people like to come back and really feel that solid back wall. But I actually personally like cable stops. It might sound weird, but I prefer those over limb stops. But I think it's a pretty good split down the middle, depending on the preference of the person.
Do people find that, I think the general impression is that a limb stop is a more solid back wall.
Sure.
Is that what you find?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, the limb stop's going to come in, and it's going to rotate, and it's going to literally stop directly on the limb. And, of course, you're not going to be able to go any bit past that. So neither of these bows have the limb stop on them. There's probably one hanging. But we sent some with the limb stop, some without. But, yeah, once it hits that limb, there's no going past it. Whereas when you're talking about a cable stop, it's coming in and it's hitting that cable. And, of course, it gives, you know, I hate to use the word sponge because it sounds bad, but it really truly is what it is, no matter what cable stop you're using from what company. It's going to give you a little bit of a feel to be able to pull in a little bit for maybe a back tension or a pull-through type release.
I think some guys like a softer back wall. You don't want to say spongy.
Yeah. Like, it's a bad connotation, but it's truly one of the words that you use.
Yeah,
you know,
but I like a little give, because when I come back, I want it gives me like a margin of error. I like settling in and just having a little give.
Sure.
Versus,
yeah,
it's like it's just too stiff. So
yeah, definitely.
Well, we appreciate you showing the bows.
Yeah,
looks like
no
you got something really good this year.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
Thanks, Kevin.
Yeah.
Product manager.
25.5 to 30, 26.5 to 31. I got to run this bracelet.
You know the bracelet?